Hey guys, and welcome to another Motivational Monday message. This is actually a message that really touched my soul, and it stemmed from a devotional that I was doing with my kids. Every night, I do this devotional with my kids. Jesus Calling, 365 Devotions for Kids from Sarah Young. I'm not sponsored by these people. I just love this devotional, and I think it's a great way to introduce the gospel to your children in a way that makes sense, in a way that's relatable, in a way that I feel like will continue to follow them even after you read the devotional. And it's divided into different days, 365. And the day that we were focusing on was October 11th, which was yesterday. And it says here, the title of it is One Thing. And it's based on James 1 verse 17, which says, "Whatever is good and perfect comes down to us from God our Father, who created all the lights in the heavens. He never changes or casts a shifting shadow." And it says here, "Every good thing in your life comes from me. Your home, your favorite things, the people who you love, they are my gifts to you. And though I have given you many pleasures and many things, not one of them is really necessary. Only one thing is truly necessary, having me in your life. Before you knew me as your savior, you thought your hopes and dreams could be met by things of this world. But now you know better. I am the one who fulfills your dreams. I do not want you to enjoy the gifts that I give you. I do want you to enjoy the gifts that I give you. But remember to thank me, the giver of all good things. And don't start thinking that you have to have these gifts. Cling to me, not my gifts. Trust me to make you complete. The one thing that you always need is the one thing you can never lose, my presence with you." And when my daughter was reading it, and my son was with me, we were all reading it together with my husband, and it was just very thought-provoking. And I asked my daughter, you know, what do you think this means? And, you know, she went through the whole thing of, oh, it just means for us to be thankful for what God gives you. And me being the person that I am, I always like to go deeper. And I, you know, was trying to explain to her, you know, what it means to solely depend on God's presence and to be able to be like Paul in Romans chapter 8, right? Who can separate me from the love of God? And I think Paul came to that notion when he realized that amongst the status he once had, you know, with the Pharisees, to him being a teacher of the law at the time, right? That was his history. To being influential, transitioning to Christianity, right? And him going from having everything to having absolutely nothing, not even his freedom. And then for him to be able to say in captivity, who can separate me from the love of God? It's because he came to an epiphany, right? He came to a moment where he began to understand the essence of Christianity, that it is not founded on things, on places, on situations, right? It is not based on blessings or curses or anything. It is solely based on the presence of God. And I began to talk to my daughter about the importance of having confidence in just the presence of God. Because sometimes, especially us as parents, right, we take our kids to church, we try our best to teach our kids to do what they gotta do, right? But then we forget to teach our children how to depend on only the presence of God, right? And then we wonder why when they go through things or when they go through troubles, the first thing they do is leave church and then don't want to have nothing to do with God, right? Because in their mind, they associate the presence of God to a building or to a ministry or to a blessing or to, you know, things that are so perishable, right? And that's because we sometimes feel that way. Sometimes we question God and all of a sudden we come to this disposition of, you know what? God cannot be real because this is not happening in my life, right? God cannot be real because I'm going through this, I'm going through that. There's something going on, there's something wrong, God, because you're not doing this, you're not doing that. Something's not aligning. I continue to fall down in this mistake. You always base the presence and the power of God on something so tangible and so perishable, when the presence of God is intangible and imperishable. Right? What do I mean by all of this? We need to learn how to put our focus, our strength, our energy, our very life on just the presence of God, and literally believing and trusting that the presence of God is enough. The presence of God is safe. The presence of God is all that you need, all that I need to be able to live this thing called life, right? In the song from our album, Broken Worship Unleashed, Make Me Yours, right? There is a line there that says, Lord, help me be able to live this life for you. The life that you've given me, God, help me live it for you and not for myself. Help me live it for you even when life doesn't make sense. Help me live my life for you even when I have successes in my life and when I have failures in my life. When people come into my life that I cherish and when people that I cherish leave. Lord, help me be able to live this life for you and that my life be founded, sifted, right? Permeated through your presence, that it be filtered through your presence, that your presence become my everything. And I think when people speak to me and they always ask me, they say, you know, Jen, you've been through a lot of things in life. And, you know, I was reflecting with this with my kids. And yes, I do have these kinds of conversations with my kids, even if they're young, because I believe that you should have these conversations with them. And I was sharing with her, you know, what I could, the best way of the things that I've been through, and just simply telling her, like, you know, look at the things that I've been through in my life, you know, from abuse, neglect, abandonment, divorce, judgment, criticism, all of these things, right? Health situations, just money, everything. Everything that I've been through personally. And I told my daughter, the only thing that's constant in my life is the presence of God. The only thing that's constant in my life that's never failed me, even when people have failed me, situations have failed me, my check has failed me, right? My health has failed me. I failed myself, right? People have failed me. So many things, but yet the only thing that has not failed me and that's kept me going to this very day, that helps me have a smile on my face even when life is not at the moment worth smiling for, right? Is the presence of God. And we have to be able to see God in a way that's bigger than our mindset. God is so much bigger than our ministry. He's so much bigger than four walls. He's so much bigger than our health, than the food we eat, right? Than the relationships we have. He's so much bigger and stronger, and he's literally, it's like what Isaiah says in the book of Isaiah, his thoughts are not our thoughts, his ways are not our ways. We cannot fully encapsulate the grandiosity of God, and sometimes we like to put God in this little box. And you know, I think that's why so many people give up on God, and why so many people leave God, and why so many people, you know, they don't want to have nothing to do with God, because all this time we've put our emphasis of our relationship with God on things that are perishable. And it's like what it says here. Under this devotional, it says, it has a bunch of other verses that you could read on your own. And out of all the verses, this one stood out to me the most. It says, I must be patient as I wait for God to help me. He is the only one that I can trust for help. He alone is the strong rock where I can hide and be safe. With him, nothing will make me fall. It is God who has kept me safe, and he has made me great. He is the strong place where I can hide and be safe. Yes, my friends, you should always trust in God. Tell him about all the troubles in your thoughts. God is our safe place to hide. Selah. Psalm 62, verse 5 to 8. And there is so much truth behind that verse. God is a safe place. His presence is a safe place. Sometimes people in situations may try to mask God's presence as a place of judgment, as a place that he criticizes and No, but if you read your scriptures, God is exactly this. a safe place. So wherever you are right now, make God your safe place and allow him to be able to hear what's in your mind, what's in your heart, what's in your soul, and what's in your spirit, so that he can help you even in the impossible. So we can change our mindset to putting him in a place where he is our everything. Not based on circumstances, not based on successes or failures, but he is our everything just because. I hope this word blesses you as much as it's blessed me, and I pray that God continues to help you get through this week. God bless you guys.